pick up with the idea that the chairman is not the problem. The chairman has tried to be the solution in many different venues, the Gang of Six. There are several members are on the committee here. You tried to sit down in a bipartisan fashion to find a comprehensive solution on the revenue spending side, so clearly your heart is in the right place. I'm sure that was a tough political exercise. But institutionally, we're broken. And that's how you get at 10%. I don't expect 100 senators to agree on a budget to get the nation out of debt. I expect about 65 of us to do that. And the only way we'll ever do that is to have a compromise. And the only way you'll have a compromise is have the base document that you can start working on. Now, we have a statutory obligation, so I reject the notion that this new process meets our statutory obligation. We're supposed to produce a budget. And people know what that means. And I would really argue to the committee as a whole, if the debt ceiling legislation is going to be seen as a budget, why do we even exist? I don't remember voting on that. I don't remember having any input. It was done by a handful of people somewhere. They met, and I don't even know what they talked about. So it would destroy this committee if we buy the idea that's an acceptable budget institutionally for the Senate. As Republicans and Democrats, we need to reject that notion that what we did to raise the debt ceiling is an adequate substitute for what this committee is chartered to do under law. And I think it would destroy the value of this committee. So I absolutely reject that what was done to raise the debt ceiling is an adequate substitute legally or just common sense-wise for the role of this committee. Now, the 2010 election, if it was about anything, it was about saving America from walking off a cliff that will damn the nation, Republican, Democrat, Independent as a whole. I think most of the people on this committee who came out of the 2010 election cycle felt like they had a mandate to do something different. That's why they wanted to be on this committee. The chairman has had that feeling for a very long time. We need to get ahead of this problem. So I think this is a serious political miscalculation by our Democratic leadership. You're not going to lose your job because you're trying to solve America's problems. You're going to lose your job if you just do the same old thing. You know, I'm going to vote for the Ryan budget, even though I'd like to change parts of it. I honestly believe, Mr. Chairman, that the public in 2010 was trying to tell us, you've gone too far, you've let it get too out of control, and we're demanding something new. So here's what's so disappointing for me, is that this great election we just had, the voice of the people did not resonate very long up here. So we're going to have a new election. And in 2012, here's what every Republican on this committee is going to say, I hope. If you give us control of the Senate, we're going to produce a budget statutorily under the requirements of the law. We're going to put our vision of how to balance the budget, deal with revenue on the table. We will work with our Democratic colleagues, but we're going to produce a document because you have to do that at home. Very few businesses are able to survive very long if they don't have a budget or a vision for their business. No family can afford to do what we've done up here. So I think we're missing a great opportunity. I think we're letting the people down who elected this new Congress. And to my new colleagues who've come on this committee, I know you've got to be very disappointed. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I thank the Senator. Senator Begich.